Okay, yeah, let's have some more fun on the YouTube. Yeah. Anyway, the vlog turd guy, 2100. 2100 its name, and it says 42 on his shirt. I wonder if that means anything. Alright, well, let's get through the fucking cartoon. Blah, 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 blah. Turn the sound down, because it's really annoying. I wonder what he says there. Eat the Jews? I don't know. Team, your webcam's broken. Whatever, that's a little gay. yeah, anyway, turn the sound up a little. Yeah, well, whatever. You know, this is a really bad video. But go ahead, do it over again.
So you made a response to my video without telling me.
Well, look, retard, you spelled my name wrong in your video. The only way I would have saw your video is I saw it as a response to, liking you guy. And, so, liking Newman, I think, liking you man. I like that name better. But who knows. But whatever. So I don't even know what this little bullshit is here. I'll make videos. You make a public video talking about me with my name in the title, even though it was misspelled, and then you're going to say, I didn't properly tell you I was making a response video. Did your response video? No. Try again, fella.
I see your outlook on humans is that everybody is an asshole.
Yeah, well, I sort of have put it that way, but really the argument's a little more complicated than that. I mean, if you want to do your little crayon drawing of it, you can do it that way. But yeah, it's a DNA problem. Yeah, we're built to be selfish. We have a selfish consciousness because it's possessed by us individually. And so then we'll often act in ways that are really stupid. You know, in the broader, bigger picture, we will fuck each other over. We will be assholes. That's right. That's sort of the nature of the animal, is to be a selfish asshole. That's my theory.
Everybody eats everybody. Nothing new from you there, is there? I mean, it's the same.
Well, look, you know, I didn't invent it, all right? I didn't invent the selfish thing. I'm the one fighting against the selfish thing. So I guess that's sort of new, all right? I mean, yeah, I'm protesting the nature. I'm saying let's rise above that and use our brains to analyze this circumstance and quit looking at it based on our own ego gratification and all the other bullshit that people use to calculate value. Yeah. So, fuck you. Anyway, go ahead.
Pessimist, bitter old man routine you've been doing for years, isn't it?
Yeah, well, I probably have been pessimistic for a long time, that's right, because there's nothing to be optimistic about. You know, you can keep talking this mush, but we see the history. I mean, I, even my pessimistic self, would have thought when I was, in the 1960s, I would have thought, oh yeah, there's no way, once there's technology and all this stuff, war will end. I mean, I had that, hippie notion that somehow we would get beyond it and we'd realize that violence can't be the way we solve problems. But here we are, with nuclear bombs, all kinds of malicious technology, and we're still solving problems by trying to kill each other. And it just isn't going to work. And there's no evidence, though, that we're not afraid to go there. Okay, we were really... Somebody knocks down a couple of buildings, and what did we do? Okay, I mean, the pattern is... We're there, and there's no reason. There's no logical reason to account for any kind of optimism that we're going to somehow see past it.
And what the fuck does Amnesty International have to do with the Palestinians dying?
I don't want to, surprise you, but Israel's been holding prisoners for 50 fucking years, all right? They capture people all the time, imprison them on the presumption. Now they basically try to kill them first. They use their big modern American airplanes to kill them while they're sleeping in their beds. But, if they can catch them, they will imprison them for crimes they can't identify them committing. Yeah, and the whole fucking Palestinian nation is basically a prisoner of war camp. Okay, Israel controls the food, it controls the water, controls the electricity.
Amnesty International is an organization made to help political prisoners, you stupid fucksquat.
Yeah, see, so you sound pretty dumb doing this bullshit, you know. That's a pretty ignorant thing to say. So you don't think the Palestinians are political prisoners of a circumstance? That the entire Palestinian people are being punished because of the nasty politics between Arabs and Jews? That makes you really dumb.
And why do you bring that up when I mention Amnesty International? That is just another straw man.
No, it was a straw man to mention Amnesty International and all these other little trivial accomplishments and say, see, that's evidence that life is getting so much better and that the human race will be just fine. It's evidence of nothing, okay? The Salvation Army is 100 and whatever years old. Have they solved poverty in America? No, they haven't. These aren't solutions to problems. These organizations are part of it. They're just part of the symptom. They're just part of what happens when you have a mess, that people will exploit the mess and try to aggrandize their ego and all this other kind of crap, but they won't solve the fucking problem.
Anyway. And you don't like Medicine Sans Frontières, hmm? Well, you know, in my book, that makes you a...
Yeah, well, in my book, like I said, I look at results, okay? The abolition movement, that was great, okay? They freed slaves, they accomplished something. Even women against drunk drivers, they accomplished something, all right? So yeah, but this idea that we're going to go around the world and just put a Band-Aid on problems, and that's all the fuck it is a Band-Aid, all right? It's not curing the disease, and it's not preventing the wound. So in my book, that's fail. It's a waste of resources. Invest in ending, invest in real solutions, not Band-Aids.
Heartless human being, but being somebody who thinks that everybody is an asshole, what can one expect from you? You were just a callous, bitter old man, aren't you?
Yeah, so that's an easy little straw-manny thing, too, you know. It's an ad hominem attack is all that is. And that's fine, okay? You want to somehow point it out with something real, though? I mean, this is just such crap. You're just going to say, you just keep talking this bullshit like it has something to do with the underlying philosophical argument that apparently you couldn't even go to the trouble of listening to, which just makes you even a bigger asshole. So you decide that you're going to make all this stink, that you're going to inject your opinion, and you didn't even listen to the videos that preface the argument. I mean, that just makes you such a fucking goddamn fool.
Out of the 7 billion humans on the planet, a lot are poor. Of that, we agree.
Well, yeah, saying a lot are poor just doesn't mean anything when you're going to start saying, well, statistically, blah, 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 and you're going to start throwing statistics around to your convenience and without context and without, it's just a lie the way you've used them and abused them. So you're just playing a game. I mean, a lot are poor. Not a lot, it's a really lot. It's a really, really, really lot.
And you just don't want to recognize the fact that many of them are getting a better life. And I think...
Okay, I mean, who had a better life? A Native American or a homeless man in New York today? I mean, this is just a stupid argument, okay? I mean... there was lots of poor people in the past, but they still had a life because they were living in, as a tribe in the nature or some other thing. Yeah, they didn't have any money, but they had a life. They weren't living off of UN food packs. They weren't completely dependent on the system functioning to survive. And when that system starts breaking down, all those people that we've kept alive aren't gonna have anything anymore except their pitchforks and their machetes. And they're going to start throwing them around a lot.
That may be because you are looking through the world through some kind of filter covered in shit.
Yeah, whatever. So if that's your argument, though, that's the extent of how seriously you're going to take the fact that 150,000 people die of measles. and how seriously you're going to take the fact that two million kids could, even if some of it's temporary, but I mean, it was even possible that 2 million kids could go blind because of a lack of a fucking vitamin. And you're just going to sit there and take those facts, and just sit there and wash it all away with some sort of notion that it's getting so much better though. Because instead of, 14% of people being, living less than 25 years, now it's 13%. I mean, this is just bullshit.
Because apparently all you can see is shit.
Why don't you just get to the real issue? You got 7 billion people on Earth, okay? Most of them are trying to live middle-class lives, civilized lives. They want their iPods. They want their electric stoves. They want all the they want their shitworm treatments. They want all the convenience that you have, all right? And they can't have them, right? I mean, we just don't have the energy. Unless we start building a lot of nuclear power plants or something, it's just not there. And you can talk about all the sustainable stuff, but who's going to pay for all the sustainable stuff? As we both can point out, America doesn't have any fucking money.
Admittedly, if you read the newspapers and read the news online, what you see is that 99% of all news are bad news.
Well, this is just another one of these little wimpy arguments. So you're going to just say that it's the news company's faults? We always know what they are. They sit there and they go look for something that's on fire. They look for something dramatic because that's how you sell news. But if people are getting their news that way, that's not, how is that my fault? Again, all right? And this assumption, that's the ultimate straw man, right? It's just to sit there and assume. And that's all you've done. I haven't turned my television on for 3 fucking years, asshole.
Is your life like that? Your own life? Is your neighbor's life like that? 99% of it is shit. It's bad news. It's like accidents, broken legs, cancer and shit.
Yeah, it really depends on where you live. But yeah, I'll sort of bring out the point that yes, some of that is goddamn true. That's right. I've seen it in my goddamn life. I've seen the cancer and shit, okay? I've seen it. I've watched people in my family die really fucking hard. Okay, because of jackasses like you with all this Pollyanna bullshit that it's all for some kind of fucking glorious reason. That the goddamn Twinkie is worth, 6 months of chemotherapy. All your desperate chasing.
Is it? If not, then why do you base your whole view of the world on what newspapers say?
Yeah, so that's not a straw man either, right? You're just saying I'm sitting here parroting the news in my videos, 2,000 videos, and they're about what's on the goddamn fucking news? Not even close, asshole. I'm the one talking about a DNA molecule and where we came from, all right? Deal with those realities. Deal with what nature is, you stupid fuckwit.
Try and read some books instead, and maybe some scientific reports.
You can't handle a 15 fucking minute video without griping. You're suggesting other people read fucking goddamn books. I guess that makes you a fucking hypocrite. Yeah, huge preposterous hypocrite. Try reading a book. When was the last time? What was the last book you read, jackass?
Just saying.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
And about the ozone hole. It has been getting smaller, actually, if you care to, maybe...
Just another stupid argument. First off, I used it as a joke, okay, just because it was convenient. But the polar caps are getting smaller, the ice is falling into the fucking oceans, the glaciers are fucking melting, so let's not pretend there's no global problem. And if the sunspots come back hard, as they're predicted to do in the next 4 years, it's supposed to be the worst sunspots in 100 fucking years, the ozone hole might get goddamn huge, you jackass. So all this talk is just bullshit. All right, so anyway, part 2 on the website.